Good morning, myself TV Suresh Kumar. I'm going to deliver a lecture regarding the subject linear integrated circuits and digital integrated circuits. In this, I'm going to cover my lecture on the topic called ADC, analog and digital converters. In analog to digital converters, input is analog in nature, that is continuous signal. We are going to convert into digital binary data. In this analog to digital converters, we are having classification as direct type ADC, direct type analog to digital converters, indirect type ADCs. Indirect type means, direct means giving input as analog signal, it is converted into binary. That is the main functioning of ADC, analog to digital conversion. Directly we are going to get input as analog in nature and we are converting into binary. Second method, indirect type ADC. In indirect type ADC, first input is analog in nature and it is converted into as a function of time or frequency. With the help of this function, again it is converted into binary. That is the reason we are calling it as indirect type. Indirect type, analog signal is converted into some other function. This function is used for converting into binary. This is the indirect type. In indirect type, we are going to have the method called as dual slope ADC. That is the topic I am going to cover. Dual slope ADC, in this main blocks are, first one, this is R and C combination. R and C means it is integrator. After this, the operational amplifier working as integrator and operational amplifier functioning as comparator. And this is a familiar one, this is AND gate. And another block we are using, your binary counter. These are the main blocks of your ADC. Operational amplifier, basic op amp working as integrator. As we are taking output across capacitance, it is your integrator. And the same output is given to another operational amplifier working as comparator. Here two voltages will be there. One is your negative voltage, another one is positive voltage. Positive terminal or non-inverting terminal is connected to ground. After this, output is given to AND gate. Then according to the output of your AND gate, your binary counter will function. These are the main building blocks of your dual slope ADC. Now, first, initially we are assuming VA is your input. Input is given to integrator circuit R and C. So here output, we can assume this is your V0, V0. V0 can be written as integrator. Integrator means minus 1 by R into C integral V in is VA dt. This is the output of your integrator. Naturally, as it is a integrator functioning with the help of inverting terminal, non-inverting terminal is grounded, and this voltage is given to inverting terminal of your operational amplifier. Another is connected to ground. Here this is zero voltage, non-inverting terminal is zero voltage, inverting is having some voltage, it is negative voltage. As it is negative voltage, this is positive voltage. Positive voltage is more than negative voltage, or you can say as non-inverting voltage is more than inverting voltage. Output of comparator is 1. Whenever inverting voltage is less than non-inverting voltage, output of comparator is 0. Sorry, output of comparator is 1 when inverting voltage is sorry, when inverting voltage is less than non-inverting voltage, output of comparator is 1. When inverting voltage is greater than non-inverting voltage, output of comparator is 0. According to that, here comparator output is 1. Whenever one of the input to the AND gate is 1, other input will be your output. So here we are using clock as another input. Whenever input to AND gate is 1, other input is clock, you are going to get the clock as your output. So here after getting the clock, main functioning of your binary counter is it will count the number of pulses. Now initially we are having reset. For the first clock pulse you are getting it as 001 010 0010, after 011 this will be continued. Suppose if you are taking in this ADC converting into 3 bit, you are going to get from 000 to 111. This binary data will be stored in the latch after 1 bit after another bit. As we are taking, this is 3 bit conversion ADC, 111 will be the last one. After this, your 1000 is the next counter. As this is MSB, this is your MSB bit. Previous MSB bits are zeros. After this, you are going to get, it is converted into 1. Whenever MSB bit converts from 0 to 1, your MSB bit makes your flip-flop or your switch will be connected to VA to V reference, minus V reference. Whenever MSB bit changes from 0 to 1, your MSB bit makes your flip-flop, the switch, to convert from VA to V reference. At that instant of time, V naught will be minus 1 by R into C, integral VA will become now minus V reference, minus V reference dt. So total it will be positive voltage 1 by RC integral V reference dt. This is given as an input to the operational amplifier functioning as comparator. Now here positive voltage, here zero voltage. As I previously told, inverting voltage is greater than non-inverting voltage, output of comparator is 0. Whenever one of the input to the AND gate is 0, any means you are going to get output as 0, your binary counter will stop counting the pulses. This is how, this is not for only 3 bit, for n bit. Whenever MSB bit changes from 0 to 1, automatically your switch will be connected to negative V reference. Negative V reference will stop your gate to produce the clock pulses. Now why it is called as dual slope ADC? Here V naught is equal to minus 1 by RC integral VA dt. Integrator, whenever you are giving some step input means your A is your, assuming your voltage level is A, you are going to get negative ramp. This is the one slope. Whenever VA is connected, you are going to have negative slope. This minus indicates your slope. Your negative going ramp is your, whenever your input is connected to VA, and minus reference is your input, means it will be going to your positive ramp. So this is one slope, this is another slope. That is the reason we are calling it as dual slope ADC. It is your having slope as 1 by RC is your, minus 1 by RC is your slope. VA is your voltage, minus indicates your negative going. This is your 1 by RC reference, minus V reference is your input. So total you are going to get your positive going ramp. This is your positive going ramp signal and this is your negative going ramp signal, completes your dual slope. So when you are converting, so in the starting only I told, your input voltage is converted into as a function of time. If you integrate, integral of constant is your t, this is also will become your t only. So this two is a functioning of time. this will be converted into binary as binary count is equal to or count is equal to counts per second into voltage. That is your, sorry, counts per second into T2. This is your T2 and this is your T1. So converting binary analog signal into function of time, this function of time will be again converted into binary count is equal to number of counts per second into time T2. So this is how you are converting your analog input to binary with the help of time function, functioning as indirect type. Thank you for listening to me.